Coach, the last play, where did you come up with that one to pull that out of your bag of tricks?
Yeah, that was New Orleans Saints goal line play. I saw they'd run it to their tight end. And Dylan, you know, he's a big physical body. I figured we'd get one-on-one at the goal line, and so we took that chance.
Is that something that you got installed this offseason, or is that something you've had in the bag for?
No, I saw it this offseason, and we just put it in. I've kind of repped it a ton, and it was a good situation for it.
Dylan Cantrell had a heck of a night for you, Coach. I mean, made some unbelievable catches.
He's a talented player, and that's what's fun. All four of those guys on any given night can really get off like that. And it happened to be his night. All of them made plays, but he had some big time catches for us.
Coach, it seemed like y'all came out with really tremendous energy tonight. Do you feel like you were able to sustain that most of the night, or do you feel like there was some ebb?
No, I think I thought the crowd was awesome to start the game. I think that really helped. You know, after the rain, you never know what's going to happen, but they came back strong and making a lot of noise. Our student section was unbelievable. So I think that helped. And then the second half, I just made some poor calls. You know, really, fourth down was an awful call and some other stuff that we could have put the game away. And so that's on me. We moved the ball well. We executed well. They got going. It was their backs were against the wall. But I could have helped us finish that game.
On that fourth and one call, what would you have called if you had?
I would have given it to the big guy up the middle. We shouldn't have went side to side on that, and that's on me. That's a bad overthinking.
Stefano, you're always happy to win any game, but how frustrating is it that you had a 21-3 and then commit all those defensive penalties? Let's just score one touchdown and then have a fumble on the goal line.
Yeah, we didn't play very well. So to find a way, I don't know if we would have won this game last year. The defense, I don't know if could have got that stop when they had to, and offense 90 yards when they had to. So I think that showed some character with this team. But when you have a chance to bury a team like we did, you got to bury them because they have talented players. You know, their back was against the wall. They got a tough stretch coming up. That was a must-win for them. We knew that we'd get their best shot, and we let them hang around, and they did a tremendous job going back, showed a lot of heart, and you got to give them all the credit in the world.
Talk about J.D. on the highest block punt of the first half, which led to a score. He's really come up big for you on special.
Yeah, that was a game changer. I mean, he's a guy we could put in any wide receiver position. He plays special teams. He does it all. You know, a walk-on from Hereford. I can't say enough good things about him and how hard he works and how much he means to our team.
Cliff, what did you think of Nick's play tonight?
Pretty good. I didn't do a good job of in the second half of keeping him going, but I felt like when it was there, he executed. He threw the ball away when he needed to, and I got to call better plays in the second half.
I know you had four play penalties on that one drive that led to the touchdown, but only six tonight, so that was a much better job tonight, wouldn't you think?
It was, yeah. Five in the first half, and second half we talked about playing a cleaner half, and they did. You know, the one that really hurt, we get the third down stop, and they get us for taunting. It didn't look like much, but they got us for it and kept the drive alive, and they scored. We can't have stuff like that.
Cliff, you've spoken highly for months now about Nick. Has he, at the same time, though, with what he's done in the first two games, has he surprised you in any aspect?
He hasn't, just because I've watched him do it now. Last fall when he got reps with the ones, last fall when the lights were on and he came into games, and then all spring and summer. You just watch him play, and you watch the great supporting cast he has, and they're in rhythm, and so it's kind of what we expected.
How would you describe your game plan against these guys different than the one you guys had 12 months ago?
You know, different defensive coordinator offensively, and defensively, they did a lot of the same stuff. They had a good plan. They got going. Manny Wilkins, you know, last year and this year played two of the best games, you know, I've seen a quarterback play against us. He was hot, could move around, make plays. The receiver was tremendous on those back shoulder fades. So, you know, it was a new year, different people involved. I was just glad that we could find a way to finish this one this year.
What was the status of Des Smith tonight?
We'll have to wait and see. I don't know if he got banged up or what was going on there.
Coach, what is Mike Lynn Thomas?
He just really, you know, lost weight, got a lot stronger in the weight room. He's gone up in his core lifts some tremendous amount, Coach Wittes had told me. And so more just work ethic and understanding what it takes every day at practice to bring that intensity, bring that effort, and really proud of where he came, you know, from 2 years ago.
Coach, talk about the run defense. Obviously,
obviously, you know, you held your opponent to 168 yards, but more importantly, you didn't allow Balazs to run all over you, roughshod. What were the difference makers for you in this game?
Yeah, I think, you know, our defensive front played hard, and our linebackers were coming downhill. And those are good players, man. Those running backs can play for anybody. The quarterback's a great player. Receiver's a good player. So I thought, you know, had a chance to bear him. When we didn't, they got hot. And that's just a game of momentum the way it goes.
Our veteran receivers breaking tackles to make big plays and big scores tonight.
Yeah, they're older, mature guys. They've been through the ringer, so they expect to make plays. We try to get in their hands. I did a poor job, like I said, the whole second half. I should have just got more completions and let them do their thing, kind of overthinking some stuff. But we'll get back to the drawing board and find a way to get it in their hands and let them do what they do.
Of course, your receiver group was outstanding tonight, not only catching the ball, but the downfield blocking. Mm-hmm. Is that a mindset that they have? Does that just speak to their veteran leadership and what they do?
No doubt. I mean, those, like I said, they take a lot of pride in being physical and attacking the defense on every play, whether they're running a route or it's a run play. That's something that group and their position coaches have really taken to a high standard.
Coach, do you think that yourself and Coach Gibbs are feeling more confidence doing things, devoting additional defenders up front? Is that because of more confidence to some guys on the back end or what they
do? Yeah, I think, you know, Octavius, you know, that guy, number one for them, I think Neil made some back shoulder catches where I thought we had great coverage, and he made tremendous catches, and Jalen Lane same way. They'll get down, and they're competitive, and get down on their face and compete, and I think that's definitely helped us on the back end.
Coach, Billy Napier made some key adjustments at halftime, which obviously led to more success for them in the second half. What would you have done differently from a defensive perspective in the second half?
Yeah, I think, I have to watch the film to see it. Like I said, a lot of those, I mean, it's fourth and four, they're throwing a back shoulder fade. We have great coverage, and the kid makes a good play. That kind of is what it is. So I felt like the momentum just shifted. They did a great job. They got hot with all their good skill players, but we found a way. Had a big time drive, big time stop to win the game.
Coach, talk a little bit about the special teams, because that was an area that was a real sore spot for you guys last year in this game. It seemed like they came to play from the start.
No doubt, they dominated us last year in field position. I think our average starting field position was the 20. Theirs was the 32 over 15 drives, 180 yards, and so we talked about that for the last 2 weeks, and that group came out and played their tails off and really gave us a chance to win tonight.
Well, you haven't seen the film from today, but what was your read on Madison Akinanu from game one, and how do you feel about what you think he did tonight?
Yeah, I mean, the obviously the competition stepped up. They have a good defensive line. He's got a ways to go. I think he saw some speed on the edge and some good defensive line, and he fought hard, you know, but I think he's just got a ways to go. I'm not sure. We're going to try to get him going over the next couple weeks if we can get his weight where we want it, and I'd say within the next 2 to 3 weeks.
Well, was it a surprise he wasn't available today? Or
no. We wanted to make sure he has a fair chance, gets his weight back up to a number that gives him a chance to compete.
Is this the kind of game that gets a team over the hump where, you know, they were ahead and then kind of gave it up and then found a way to win? Is this one of those games that just confidence builders and moving through the season you kind of build on?
I hope so. We didn't win these last year. You know, we were in a bunch of close ones, 4 or 5, that came down to the end, and we never won them. So to find a way, you know, the defense gets that stop, sets up our drive, and then gets a sack and holds them when they have the ball to go down and win it, you know, that can build some character.
Cliff, what was your message? What was your message to Desmond after the fumble at the goal line?
Just we're going to need him again. You know, he was just trying to do too much. You can't reach out down there. It's first down. Just he's a big guy. Keep running your feet, and you know, he'll learn from it.
Anything else? Coach, is Vontae Dorsey 100%?
We'll have to check on it. I think he had some sort of ankle, it looked like. But I saw him after the game, so we'll see. I don't know the official word on it.
Dylan, that last play, did you was that something you guys have been working on quite a bit? Was that a surprise, or was that something you just kind of looked at and went, okay, this is the time for it?
No, we had it in the install. We've been working on it for a couple of weeks. But, yeah, great job by the O-line. Great seal block on the edge by Dante Thompson, cutting off that corner, and then just got to find a way to get in.
So you expected that call to come sometime tonight?
I mean, it was in the game plan. So, yeah, if it was the right situation, then we were going to roll with it.
When's the last time you scored?
my freshman year in high school. So it's been a while.
Were you a receiver then too?
I was. It was a little 1 yard, basically the same type of thing, a little 1 yard jet sweep. So
you caught everything that was thrown at you tonight, even a ball out of bounds that they looked at, but it was probably because they just didn't feel like it must have been inbounds. I mean, was this just a special night for you? Just kind of feel it from the very beginning?
I mean, that's one thing that as a receiving core that we work on every day is just, I mean, we take a lot of pride in is catching everything that comes your way. You know, Nick put the ball exactly where it needed to be every time on that post. You know, perfect ball, the back shoulder fades. You know, that was one thing that was open, playing a lot of bail technique, and so that the back shoulder fade was there. And, you know, he put it where it needed to be, and you just got to find a way to make a play.
Which was your favorite out of those catches that you made?
I you know, maybe the one on the shoulder if I had to pick. But, yeah, I just, you know, I try to just put my team in every position we can to get in the end zone and move the chains, so. Yeah, no doubt. You know, we have some of the most electric guys in the country, you know, that are dangerous with the ball in their hands. You got Kiki and Cam who are quick, and, you know, me and Derek who are a little bit bigger and kind of try to run people over a little bit. But, yeah, I mean, that's a lot of – we take a lot of pride in that, just making big plays and when your number's called, making a play.
45-45, you had 90 yards to go. What did you see out of Nick in the huddle at that time?
Oh, I mean, he's a leader. You know, throughout that whole game, you know, we never had any doubt that we were going to go down and score at the end. And, you know, we came out hot, had it going. Defense was rolling the first half. Hats off to Arizona State. They came out in the second half ready to play and made a lot of big plays. I know their receiver made a lot of big plays, running backs, quarterback. You know, they have great players. They're a good team. And, you know, when it comes down to it, defense made big stops and offense made a drive to go win it. So that's what we got to do. They didn't change up. You know, we just kind of hit a dry spell and just got to stick to what we know and make those routine plays. And, you know, that can't happen. We got to be better than that.
What did Nick say in the huddle right before that last touchdown?
Yeah, I mean, you know, they had the timeout, and it was between that and another play. And just he looked at me and, you know, he has some confidence in me. And my teammates, they looked at me and they just said, you know, we have the confidence in you. Just find a way to get in the end zone.
How about the downfield blocking tonight by the receiver group? Is that something you guys take a lot of pride in? Because boy, it sure was evident tonight.
No doubt. You know, you see a lot of teams, guys taking plays off at the receiver position in the run game. But that's one thing that, you know, we've stressed since day one is downfield blocking and just, you know, doing anything you can to help the running backs out. For me, there's no better feeling, you know, sometimes better than a touchdown. If you get that spring block and you see the running back run by you for a touchdown, there's no better feeling than that.
Dylan, you got asked forever about your rapport with Pat. How is it with Nick? Because it seems like y'all kind of have that same already. Seems to have already had that same kind of chemistry.
Yeah, I mean, Nick's been here for almost 4 years now, so we've got countless reps, and you know, that's one thing this offseason. As soon as Pat declared, that's one thing that we made it a big deal and stressing every, you know, 3 or 4 times a week, going out and doing extra routes and just getting that timing down. And I think it's worked out for us, and we got to continue to build on it.
I know you probably don't necessarily want to bat mouth an opponent, but Arizona State was last in the nation in pass defense the last 2 years. So you guys kind of feel like, hey, tonight we need to go out and take advantage of that and have a big night.
I didn't even know that. Like I said, they have a lot of fight in them. You know, down 20 points or so at halftime, and coming out and making it a game. And so, you know, like I said, hats off to them. But we have a lot of fight in us too. It's probably a game, you know, the past year or two, I'm not sure if we would have pulled it out. That's one thing that we've stressed this whole offseason is finishing the games. And that's one thing that we lacked at last year. And so hopefully this will give some confidence and we'll build off of it. Hey, like I said, just had some great blocks and then just find a way to get in. Kind of maybe thought I would have a chance to have to dive at it. you know, really focusing on staying in bounds no matter what, because we want to keep the clock running, and then had a chance and had to make a play. So.
How's it help beating a team under this much pressure and, you know, in a game that's a must win for them?
Yeah, I don't even think we thought about it like that. We just approach every game the same and, you know, prepare as well as possible and go out there and try to make plays and help our guys out and get the win. So I think we approached it as if we were going against anybody in the country.
Your move to get the fumble or getting off the field with the ball?
I was just trying to get off the field to give the offense the ball back so they could score. That's all I was trying to do.
What'd you see when you saw it?
Oh, I see he had kicked the ball at first. I didn't think I was going to get to it at first. And I see I had the opportunity to get on the ball, and I grabbed it.
Just overall for the defensive line, I guess how important was it for y'all just to kind of step up that middle? Because it seemed like they were trying to avoid that a little bit early on, and they were trying to go to the side. So I guess how important was that for y'all just to establish the middle?
It was very important. We just had 2 weeks of preparation on them, and we knew what we had to do. So we made sure that we did our job.
What was different for you guys this year against
Balazs?
I mean, was that a goal to kind of shut him down, I guess?
It really wasn't a goal. Last year we were just young, and this year we just stepped it up. We had, like I said, we had 2 weeks of preparations on them. So it wasn't a goal. We just knew what we had to get done.
You actually had a little defensive back play there at the end of the game. Is that instinct that you just were going for the ball and looked up and all of a sudden you're covering the receiver?
I seen them go out, and my instinct was just to take them because I feel like I don't know if nobody was behind me, and I just we made a good play, and I did a good job. Thank you.
Anything else? You also had the sack. You got four tackles in the first half. Was that one of your best games?
Since last year, yes, it's been one of my best games. This game been one of my best games.
Coach Kingsbury talked about your work with Coach Witt and your strength and all that. Is it kind of look at tonight as a payback for all that effort that you put in?
Yes, sir, it's a very payback. I was working my butt off during the off season, during fall camp to get bigger, get stronger. So I appreciate Coach Witt and his program.
What y'all do during the weather delay?
We just stay focused. Make sure we stay focused and knew what we had to do. Don't lose focus of the game and just.
Since it had been a while since pregame meal, did y'all have any snacks or were y'all just hanging out?
Hanging in the locker room, we had snacks too. So we was just hanging out in the locker room and eating for a little bit.
What was Coach's message after you guys scored that touchdown? You guys had to go out there and get that stop.
He just said, let's get a stop. It was on us, defense win games, and they were dependent. Our team was dependent on defense, and we did what we had to do.
What's that do for guys like Zach Barnes and Eli Howard, who kind of managed the quarterback to get that last sack?
It was a good play. We was just trying to get out the field. They had a penalty, I think, also a penalty, so that helped us better. Just to get that sack, just sealed the deal to win the game.
So, Nick, what's going through your mind when it's 45-45 and you know your work is not done?
Got to score. Each and every drive, you know, no matter what the defense is doing or what the situation is, first quarter, end of the game like that, whatever the case might be, the goal is to score a touchdown every drive. So, you know, I was trying to calm those guys down a little bit. I know I could sense the, I wouldn't say nervousness, but maybe anxiousness, urgency to make a play. Just one of those guys to relax, stay within themselves, and ultimately that's what we did, found a way to win.
You feel like you said you wanted to calm them down. You felt pretty calm yourself.
Yeah, you know, I got a little frustrated there in the second half. It seemed like they were pretty much had a good play call for everything we ran as opposed to the first half. But, yeah, you know, even I had to tell myself, as I was telling those guys, you know, calm down, we got this, I kind of had to take a step back and tell myself that because, like I've mentioned in the past, I'm a very emotional player. At times, I get too high in the highs and too low in the lows. So going back to what I said, I need to take a step back while I'm telling them to calm down. I need to tell myself to calm down as well. So
when that play call came in, the last one to do the handoff to Dylan, what was going through your mind when that play call came in?
I knew it was going to work. Situations like that in any football game, you got to give your best player the football, and he's one of our best players. I knew he was going to, if there was four or five dudes over there, he was going to find a way to get in the end zone, as big, strong, and fast as he is. But, yeah, I was very confident in the play call. As soon as he said it, as soon as Coach Kingsbury said it, I knew, all right, this is our game. So, and like I said, Dylan, he wasn't going to be denied. So it was a great effort by him.
How would you say he was an asset in this game? Like, he seemingly never let the ball hit the ground.
Yeah, you know, that's who he is. He's probably got the best hand-eye coordination, the best ball skills anybody I've ever been around. High school, Iowa here. You know, he makes plays. I threw him one back shoulder and the dude was draped all over him, face mask, before the ball even got there. The ball kind of just stuck to him. He one-handed it, got a foot in. But that's what he does, you know, that's what he does in practice. I have a ton of confidence in him that he's gonna come down with the ball every time I throw it to him. So, yeah, he's a great target. He's a great asset to have over there. Well, there's also a negative to that. We didn't finish as well. This coming up week, we need to put the two games together. Started slow last week, finished strong. Started faster this week, and just didn't finish. Found a way at the end. But you know, it's a work in progress. It's only the second game of the year. But yeah, moving forward, we just need to put together four quarters. We played about as bad as we could play in the second half leading up to that last drive, offensively, defensively. But in this league, a win is a win. Whether you win by one or you win by 50, a win is a win. That's the goal, to go 1-0 every week. And we accomplished that goal, so moving on to Houston.
How much will this team take from this win in terms of confidence building forward? You get a big sense of that this is a big momentum win for you guys?
Yeah. I'm not sure we would have won that game last year. Just the backs against the wall, needed a play. The offensive line, man, the offensive line that last drive, if we wouldn't went down there and scored, that whole game would have been my fault because the offensive line was giving me so much time. If I couldn't find nobody, if I couldn't make any throws right there, you know, I don't know what I'm doing up here. So, and then as far as the defense goes, they got a minute and 55 seconds left, I believe, to go score. And an offense like that, that's nothing similar to us. And we were fortunate to make some plays. Justice Parker made a great play with a pass deflection. Got the sack. Sloppy in the second half, I would say. Sloppy in the second half, but found a way to get it done. And at the end of the day, that's all that matters.
Kiki and Dylan both were way over 100 yards. Of course, Derek and Cameron both made big plays, too. How much did it seem like to you your first read was open tonight, and how many of those big plays were maybe second or third guy that you looked for?
You know, there was a couple. The touchdown to Dylan was a fourth read, the post, in the first half. Yeah, it was a fourth read. I guess third. They did a great job getting open. Like I said in the past, you get those guys the ball. I threw a little bubble to Cam in the first half. Bad ball, threw it down at his knees. He had to bend down and get it, stop his momentum, and then makes the dude fall on the ground and goes for a touchdown. It's a blessing to have guys like that you can just shoot it out there and anything can happen. I'd probably say the play of the game It was 3rd and 10, and I found Cam for a first down. He did a great job getting open. Great job of knowing where the sticks were, just finding it, getting a first down. And that goes back to having chemistry with these guys, you know, working all spring and summer, just being on the same page. So. He wasn't. I was looking. It was 3rd and 10. I was looking to go one of the big boys outside, hoping they would just get into their guy and make a play. But, you know, they sat on it. They played a good defense for what we called. And going back to the offensive line, man, I felt like I had 7-8 seconds back there. And then Cam found a hole, shot it to him. And like I said, he did a great job knowing where the sticks were, getting the first down. And went on to score after that. So.
What did you think of Justin Stockton tonight? Because he ran the ball really, really hard and made some big catches for you, too.
Yeah, we just got to keep trusting him, give him the ball. He's a very explosive guy. He always has been. Just got to be consistent. If it doesn't work, first, second play, one or two runs in a row, just be consistent, feed him. Eventually, he's gonna hit a hole, and he's gonna find a lane and make a big play. And the same with Nisby. That's what I kept telling Nisby. He fumbled in the end zone. He's kind of down on himself, but you know, I think it was the second quarter at that time. I was like, you know, we got this whole game. That's not the last touch you're gonna get the rest of the season. You know what I mean? You gotta flush it. Being a quarterback, obviously, we have to have a quick memory for interceptions and sacks and fumbles. So. I was trying to relay that message to him to get him a little more upbeat. But, you know, those guys are doing a great job. And as long as we keep running the ball, it's going to make it easier on everybody, me, the receivers, everybody.
Arizona State had 10 sacks the first two games. So all those guys across the defensive front made a bunch of plays so far. Were you thinking going into this game you're going to have to throw on time? And also, how much – was there much talk this week about the offensive line? Hey, you guys, this is a big challenge for y'all to get to come through.
No, I trust those guys up front. I trust all five of them. I trust Coach Brandon Jones to put them in the right situation to be successful. You know, there was never a, I'm about to drop back. I got to get it out quick. Here they come. It was never like that. I knew they were going to pick up who they needed to pick up. And the rest is on me. There was two or three sacks. I think I got sacked three or four times. One or two of them were my fault. Just got to be able to get the ball away. I know there was one play where I was running around back there. Seemed like 20, 30 seconds. Ended up taking a sack. Just got to play smarter overall. So.
One more. You mentioned you had calming words for the team. What did you say before that game when it touched
down? That we got to score. We didn't have a choice. You know, like I said, it seemed like everybody was antsy, anxious, urgent. But me personally, whenever my back's against the wall, I've always been this way. It seems like I play a little better. So I was fired up for the moment. I was just trying to tell my offensive line, you know, they're getting tired. It's the end of the game. They really haven't been subbing a lot. You're gonna be able to block them, and if y'all do that, you can trust me. I'm gonna make the play. So, a little too close for comfort, I'd say. The game got a little too close for comfort, but I wasn't gonna let that one slip away. So.
Dylan said the last time he scored a rushing touchdown was his freshman year in high school. Who was the last team that you beat on a drive late in the fourth quarter?
Man, I don't even know. That's a long time ago, Don. That's a long time ago. I don't even remember.
You said your first game, it was awesome to be out there. You still got that feel?
Oh, yeah. The delay, I try to not let the delay affect me or us as a team, as a unit. Stay hype, keep those guys amped up. But, man, you only get 12 of these guaranteed. So, especially at home, anytime you get a chance to play in front of your home crowd, and they were awesome tonight, you got to take advantage of it. Simple as that. So.